Today I'll be reviewing for you this essential weekly A5 planner from Aura Estelle. But first, if you're new here, hey, my name is Lauren, and on my channel I talk all things planning and self-care. If you are a returning subscriber, you might notice that I am filming in a different spot, and I might sound a little different than usual. This is because I am recovering from some kind of bug, and my voice is not up to par yet, and I didn't want to delay filming this review because this is going to be the planner that I'm going to be moving into. So I wanted to film before I start writing all over the place. If you've been around for a while, you probably will know that I don't think I've ever filmed while I am recovering from sickness or anything like that. I assure you, I have been resting a lot, and I feel so much better today than I did yesterday. Yesterday was pretty bad. So I'm good. I'm fine. Thanks for the well wishes, because I know you guys will send those to me. But let's get into this planner. If I would have seen this earlier, I definitely would have picked it up because it's a layout that I have been hunting for. So let's start first with the cover. I think the cover is some sort of coated cardstock because this inside is definitely a cardstock. Oops, I just dropped my pen. And this is like the end paper, it's like a cardstock. So I think this is just coated because it's not the most pleasant feeling either. And I do believe this only came in like a black. I don't think I had an option for any other color. And it's a collaboration with Aura Estelle and Annie Plans. I believe this is the third year, maybe, for this. I don't know if this specific layout is in its third year or not, but if you do like this layout, she has other sizes with very similar, like almost the exact same layout, but like in different sizes. And this one's dated. They do have undated versions as well. It is a Canadian company, so it did take a little while to get to me, but that's okay. It had the layout I really wanted, so that's why I went ahead and got it. Another thing to note is that it is Tomoe River paper, which I didn't think that I would actually get a planner that has this paper because of the ghosting situation that tends to happen, but I found a trick and I will talk about that later, but let's go ahead and flip through it. Another reason why I didn't think I'd ever be in one is because most planners that are like book bound like this with the Tomoe River paper, they have calendars that are Monday starts, and these are Sunday calendars. Hallelujah, finally. I don't think any other brand is doing Sunday start. So if you are like me and you want your Sundays on your months to be like the start and you want your weeks to be Mondays, this is the Tomoe River planner for you. I don't think I've seen anything else. So here you have the calendars, and then here you have the, what are they calling this page? Okay, now my cold memory or brain fog situation is happening, but let me grab for you. This is a Moterm cover that I am planning to use for this book. And I'm pulling out this Hobonichi pencil board to show you the ghosting thing, because I'm sure on my camera you can see the calendars behind this, but don't think this is going to work unless it's this gray one, but I could be wrong. Put the pencil board behind and look. Now you cannot see. It's like magic. So look. You can't see it. You can't. It's insane. So the reason I have this is because my daughter was using a Hobonichi cousin, which I should go grab that for you and show you the size comparison, because I know I'm going to get that question. But I will say the MD cover that you can get, the clear cover that you can get to cover the Hobonichi Cousin. This, I know this fits on the Hobonichi Cousin because this is, we got like a pack to cover her cousin. And then this is another one from that pack that I am using to put on this before I put it in the leather cover. And this fits on there perfect. I know there's a difference between this year and last year's print. Well, two differences that I've heard, because I've seen some reviews from the last year, from the 2023 version of this planner. One, the ink pigmentation is darker this year. So last year was a little bit on the light side, so they bumped it up a little bit so it's darker, which I like. And two, the number of extra notes pages that you get in the back has increased. So this has month views, weekly views, and a whole bunch of notes pages in the back. Not enough notes pages in the back for you to have a day for every day of the year, but enough for maybe half the year. I'd have to pop up on the screen like the number of pages in the back, but it's a lot. So here's the other 6 months. The planner came with this cute, this little cheat sheet, and I'm going to show you while we're on this page. Yearly overview. That's what they call this page. So I'm going to hold it up here. I really like the idea of this mood tracker. I've never thought about doing a mood tracker like this. And also, like, it wasn't until I saw this that if you pay close attention, the mood tracker, like, people are notating dots for like multiple days. I just noticed that, like, February has 29 days on here, but yet they marked like a 30th with mood. That's definitely a mistake. But okay, sometimes you have like more than one mood during the day. You're not necessarily like stuck in that same mood. So I really like the idea of this type of a tracker and doing it like that. Also indicating like if you went to bed early or if you went to bed late on certain days, also to kind of help you see if like that correlates to maybe how your mood differentiates the next day. That's a really cool idea. But otherwise, the recommendation here looks like a daily gratitude, which I think that's really cool. I don't know if that's enough space for me. I would definitely want more space than that, but that's a good idea. And then this would be just like a future log. That's how I think I might use this, these pages for in the front, to plan ahead or like what I have like supposed to be happening, or when's holidays or birthdays and things like that. And turn to these pages when I'm setting appointments. But I thought that was a really cool extra that was popped into here. So I'll look at the rest when we get to other pages so you can see examples that they've given. But so after these overview pages, you get a full spread. And hold on, you can see through right there. Let me, you can see. It's two dot grid, not dot grid. Graph grid. All the pages in here are graph. There's graph everywhere. So this one's a graph. So you've got this before you get into January, which I started to back date, back plan a few things just to kind of get an idea. And like I said, these are Sunday start. And you do have like a section here, and then you've got sections all along here that you can use to do, you know, whatever you want with. I really like the font. I really like that these numbers are huge and they're not super tiny. My eyes are closer to 40 than they are to when I was young. And I just appreciate the bigger numbers. Now, I'm looking close, and now that I'm looking close, this and Sunday are both kind of in a grayer font than Monday through Friday. I don't know if the camera is picking that up, but these are definitely darker than the Weekend. That's the only thing. And there's absolutely no color. It's just gray. This planner doesn't have any color at all, which if you've ever used any Hobonichi planners, you know that they have a thing with colors, especially on this page with reds and blues, I believe it is. I forgot to show you the monthly options here. So it's pretty basic, but this is what the sample looks like. Oh, cool. I like this idea right here of indicating like repeated things happening. And it looks like they use an initial, I guess this is like the name of a person in the family. So they use like a color coding system. So these days, there's a phonics from 3 to 4. And then on these days, it looks like the library is open from 10 to 12, or that's when like you're planning to visit. So that's a really cool idea for like repeat events, is to kind of put like a little key down here for what they mean. Okay, so this planner does not have all the months up front. So they are dispersed with the weeks, which I like. I don't like it when they're all up front. So you do get a blank. I keep saying blank. If I say blank at all through the rest of this, just know I mean graph grid. You get 2 graph grid. You can use this for what you want. Since I'm in the Moxie Life system, I could totally see this page being useful for putting my goals, if I wanted to, for the month, putting them in here after already like figuring them out in my Moxie Life, so that I can also have them in here, because I do figure things out over there and then migrate things into here to make sure they actually get done. But that would be a good spot. Or you can use this for just like a master to-do list for the month, or I might even use one of these pages for my kids' schedules during like busy sports seasons when they have like a bunch of games and I don't want to clutter up the actual calendar with all the details of it. I can use one of these pages for that reason. Heck, I could even print out their schedule and like stick it in here. That might be better. Okay, then this is what the week looks like. So it basically has Monday through Sunday broken up into evenly spaced sections. And I do believe these grid spacings in here are the same as the Hobonichi. I'll have to pop up that information, because I can pull from Hobonichi site and Aura Estelle and figure out, I'm pretty sure that it's the same spacing. And these are all equally spaced. There's like 7. There's 7 boxes high, each of them. And then you've got this column over here that you can use for something. You can use it maybe like for a to-do list. Hang on, I just realized I'm a little bit off frame. Okay. You can use it like a to-do list or whatever. But then you have like a little calendar up here that the week is shaded very faintly. These weekends are grayed out a little bit too. So I really like that. I really like the font. You've got a week number at the top. So I am finally going to know what week it is throughout the year. I've never had a planner that had it already in there before, and I've never bothered to like try and number it, or to even care for that matter. So now I'm going to be like on top of it that it's already there. So that's cool. And this side is just a graph grid page, blank, as in it doesn't have any, well, you can see through that. It doesn't have any markings on it at all. You can use it however you want. So you can split it down the middle and make like a to-do list. I'm looking carefully and I do not see any dots. Sometimes planners, they put little markings around to help you if you're going to split it like immediately in half here or here. But I don't see any markings of that kind. So you'd have to count if you want to divide it a certain way. I do see markings here though, on this edge. Like every other, For every two, there's a little dot right there. Can the camera see that? I'm not sure exactly why. But let me show you this. So this is a sample week. It says reference dots for lists or notes. Interesting. I guess so that you can easily space things apart so that it's not like all squished together or whatever. But look, the column right here is 1.5 inches. So a lot of stickers, a lot of sticker kits, they're that wide. So if you're curious to know if any of your 1.5 stickers fit there, they will. And then over here is a sample of how like they used the free, they're calling it a free grid page. There is a little marking over here. As you can see right here, it says monthly tabs to remind you of the current month you're in. But I think, I mean, that's kind of weird wording. It's more because it doesn't have tabs. If you look on the edge, you can see all of that. So you can find what month to go to. But yeah, so that's how this is laid out. And then when you get to the end of, yeah, I started back planning a little bit of what happened this past week. I'm filming this on the 29th. So it goes to the next month. And then again, with some grid pages that are free to use how you want, next month, and that's how it flows. So at the end of the planner, I told you there are a bunch of notes pages, and I don't think they're numbered. Let me make sure. No, there's no numbering on them at all. So if you wanted to number it for some kind of index, you would need to do that on your own. But I did do some pen testing, and the pen that fell on the floor is, the body is one of those air grip. But the one that was in here originally exploded, and I replaced it with just a regular Sarasa Dry, but in the 0.4. And that is the pen that I wrote right here in the actual planner when I was pre-planning, because I really like the body of this too. But also the combination of that pen in here, it gives me a little bit of a resistance to make it so that it doesn't feel like I'm just like, whew, sliding across this paper. And I did like a smudge test pretty quickly after it, after I wrote on it. I just spit on my paper. Now it's contaminated. Anyway, this, the Sarasa R, it hadn't been used in a while. So when I first wrote this line, that's why it's crossed out. It was kind of writing really light. And then the more I wrote with it, it started getting like a bolder. So I think it was just like that. And then I was alternating between writing with the Sarasa R and the Sarasa Dry. And they both, like what I'm describing is, they both work obviously because like smear test wise, but the Sarasa R, it just felt a little bit more scratchy. And it was like making a little bit more of like a scratchy sound when I was writing on it versus this one. But they both work like completely fine. I'm trying to use just what I have and not go by anything else unless I run out of what I'm using, because I've got a bunch of refills for the this one that I need to use up. I will probably be doing a setup video for this because I do not plan on just using it like this. I'm gonna put it in that cover I showed you, and I'm going to set up some of these pages in here, and I guess it can show you like how I got that set up once it is set up. So it's not gonna be a setup video where you sit down and set it up and watch me set it up. I'm just gonna do it on my own because I don't really have the energy for that right now. I'm hoping that goes out next after this, like in a week from this video. So make sure you subscribe if you aren't already so you can see that if you're interested in it. And I appreciate you listening to my raspy sounding voice, even though you could be listening to a bunch of other videos today. I hope that you are staying healthy and warm, and until next time.